Hi, and welcome to another episode of Hot Takes with me, the Silver Fox. There is, I think, a perfect storm coming. We all know the SNP are desperate for money and are looking for new and innovative ways of raising it. And we also know that their partners in crime, the Greens, are looking for ways of destroying the economy. And boy, have they hit on the perfect answer. The solution that will both raise a little bit of money until the industry is destroyed, and therefore the SNP get a bit of cash, and the Greens have another sector utterly destroyed, and therefore they will feel happy as well, because they don't like the idea of people being happy, or having money, or doing anything constructive. And of course, Wonder Boy, the Ginger Twiglet, is in charge of this, and so he will be creaming his little Y-fronts at the thought of inflicting even more misery on an already embattled sector of Scottish industry, this being the tourist industry. And what is the cause of his pleasure and everyone else's sheer misery? It's the plans to introduce now a tourist tax, because going to Scotland for a holiday isn't difficult enough as it is, with all the hotels and bed and breakfasts closing down thanks to the licensing scheme. Now tourists will be charged even more. It's almost as though they don't want anyone to come to Scotland and spend money, which is exactly what they want. Let's have a look. So SNP tourism sector to paper over the cracks of brutal budget cuts ahead of key vote. They seem to think that a tourist tax is going to raise enough money to make a difference. It won't. The only way you have a tourist tax high enough to make a difference is if it's so high, it absolutely drives tourists away. It's a catch-22 designed by a moron. And talking of which, there he is. Look, Scotland's most manly man, a man who only takes his protein in liquid form from Mr. Pervert, Patrick Harvey. Holyrood will debate and vote on the introduction of a tourist tax with the plans originally put forward by the Scottish Greens. Ho-hum, did we not think it was anything else? Do you know, here's an example of what not to do. If you're a parent and you think, do you know, I want the most ineffective nothing of a son. Raise him to be like that. A man who's very stupid. He didn't go to, he turned up at university, but it was a bit hard. And it was filled with people who had views that were opposite of his. He couldn't handle it. And he ran away after one term and never returned. He's never had a real job, of course. So he's joined the Greens. They lapped him up. Look at this. A young twink with no job experience, no education, and for whom we can mould and meld the way we want. And then send him out in the world so that he can pontificate on all his vast experience and knowledge. Never had a stake in his life, has he? The SNP is using Scotland's vital tourist sector to plaster over the cracks after years of financial mismanagement. It has been claimed, as MSPs prepare to vote on a tourist tax. Holyrood will debate the visitor levy. They can't call it tourist tax. They don't like the word tax, so they change it to the word levy, which means tax. This would give local authorities new powers to charge a fee on overnight stays. That's fine. People won't pay it. People stay at home. Why should you pay it? Why should you? This again is another attack on the tourist industry. It's not supporting, it's not benefiting the tourist industry. The tourist industry is not going to benefit one jot from a single penny of this tax. It will go into the central coffers, it will be wanked away on a load of old shite that nobody wants or needs. Meanwhile, what it will do is damage the tourist industry even more at a time when they need all the help they can get. And maybe even driving some of them out of business. Ultimately, that's tax loss to the government and people going on the dole, creating even bigger drain on resources. Joined up thinking, not something you assume with the SNP. The legislation proposes a new surcharge would be a percentage of visitors' accommodation costs and would apply to those staying in hotels, hostels, bed and breakfasts, self-catering accommodation, campsites and caravan parks. Wild campers and people in motorhomes and campervans who pitch elsewhere would not be covered. Yeah, you can't police it. In fact, they can't police this anyway, can they? The legislation was proposed by the Scottish Greens before they became part of the executive. There are fears that the levy could drive away tourists. Well, no shit, Sherlock. by adding a new financial burden amid the cost of living crisis. And the Scottish Tories have warned the nationalist government that money may be used by councils to plug financial gaps in the budget after brutal cuts were handed down. That's it. They won't go to improving the tourist industry. They'll go to filling the gaps. Just so that, you know, for example, old Two Seats can get another flight off to foreign climes, quaffing that champagne at 30,000 feet. She can get the tourists in Scotland to pay for it, as well as everyone else. Just think, another load of Greggs to shove down her immense face. Shadow Secretary for Business, Economic Growth and Tourism Murdo Fraser said there would be a benefit from a visitor levy if we could be sure that the money would go directly to enhancing local services to make those locations more attractive to tourists. Do you think that's going to happen, children? No, of course it isn't. It's going to go in and pay expenses for the councillors to go and spend holidays and masturbate hugely on their iPhones. He says, but as it stands, there's the danger it will impose an additional financial burden during a cost of living crisis, discouraging tourists from visiting Scotland, and it is unclear how it will be administered. And given the systemic underfunding of councils over the years of SNP mismanagement, it's likely that any revenue raised would simply be used to plaster over the cracks in services that should be provided as a matter of course, and for which residents are already paying. And of course that's what's going to happen. This is just another iniquitous tax put on by a desperate government looking to tax every single thing they can because of their mismanagement. But it's also, of course, just the basic lunacy of the Greens. Don't ever think that Ross Grier could ever come up with anything good. He is a cancer. He is the waste of a cancer. When a cancer is treated, he's the bit of the cancer that they don't even study. He's the bit of the cancer they hack off and throw in the bin. Because that's all he is. He's a cancerous little parasite. He gives nothing. He does nothing. He contributes nothing. He's a stealer of air. That's what he is. But I'm sure his mummy is very proud of him as he sits there taking bitty every evening, patting him on the head. Well done, Ross. You're a big boy now. You've made it all the way to Holyrood. What a complete wanker. Oh, well. West of Scotland Green MSP Ross Grier, the wonderful manly Ross Grier, said tourists obviously don't pay council tax. Yes, they do. They just pay it in their own council. So what you're saying, anyone from Scotland comes to England has to pay a come to England tax. Is that what you're saying, Ross? I mean, really? Are you such a cock? Yeah. So a small levy on their overnight stay is a fair way to ensure that local residents aren't picking up the bill. That's bullshit. That's bullshit and he knows it. Local residents benefit from the tourists going there and spending money in the bars, the restaurants, the shops, etc. They are already contributing. That's how tourism works, you brainless prick. Anyway, he said it's a small charge, but it won't be, that will make a big difference here in Scotland. It won't. If it's a small charge, it won't make a difference. The only way it makes a difference is a big charge, and if it's a big charge, no bugger will go to Scotland. They're doing everything they can to dissuade people. Let's make the beer expensive. Let's reduce the number of short-term lets. Let's put taxes on you staying. It's basically, hoi, English people, stay out of Scotland. It's bigotry. That's all it is. Unfortunately, the people of Scotland are really going to suffer for it. But they keep voting for them. You keep voting for these pricks. You get what you deserve. Stop voting for the likes of Ross Grier. He is a shit stain on the underpants of Holyrood. I'm stopping now and I'm coming up, but I'm not bloody wrong, am I? The ginger twiglet is like all of them in Greens. They think they're virtuous. They think they're wise. And they say, listen to us. We are the caring ones. We are the wise ones. No, you're all extremist Marxist pricks. And you hate the fact that people enjoy themselves. You hate the fact that people may be happy. You hate the fact that people have got money and private ownership of shit that you ain't getting your hands on. That is why you keep wanting to do all this. You want a misery-strewn desolation. So that you can sit there and look like the great saviours of humanity. Oh, you are the ginger messiah. No, Ross Grier, you're just a silly little boy playing with the adults in the room. And everybody looks at you with utter contempt. Now run back to mummy, do some growing up and get some life experience and maybe a real job, and people may just listen to you one day. But until then, all they see is a child in his daddy's clothes. Thank you very much for watching. Do please hit that subscribe button, ring the bell, leave a like, leave a comment, please share the video. Till next time, stay safe, stay well, and I will speak to you later. Bye.